Season 2 of the Pat and JT podcast. Oh my, now I'm here at last. The best time, always gonna be the best. Come on! Exclusively on the Herd App Media Network.
Right. You think after the third time we move our office, she wouldn't be able to find us? For the love of God.
Suckers.
It's like feral cat out front, knocking on the door.
You know you love me.
Do you guys move?
Mange and everything. Mange. You're like, come on in.
We'll feed you.
No one else is taking you.
Right? Take you. Mange and everything.
And everything. The whole nine yards. That's awesome. God, it's about time to get you back in here. But we haven't been here that long, so it's not like...
Right.
You know,
she waited. She didn't wait at all.
Well,
she
here's the deal. I admitted to Jill. I said, because you want to come see us? Which, proactive by Jill.
You're already
FYI.
Knock on the door.
And I said, sure. Then she sent the new address. And I thought, oh, God. Have they been talking about this on the podcast? Like, will this be my moment of truth? And I'm like, I didn't know you moved. I'm sorry.
So did you play it coy and be like, okay, cool, thanks? Or did you say, oh my God, you moved?
No, I never am coy. Okay. The emotions are on the surface. What?
She's like, no, I have to, full disclosure, I had no idea you guys moved.
You guys have a podcast?
Yeah, right.
Thanks, Heidi.
This is uptown. This is a
nice. This is legit.
Out of all your places, this is the best.
Yeah.
It's been quite the journey. Yeah. And that coffee maker.
I was just going to say that. Yeah. This place has by far the best coffee maker.
I started the coffee maker up just so she could see it.
Did you show her the process of putting the bag in
and
everything?
I did.
That's
not.
Like science. Oh, dude.
So cool. And you don't have to empty it.
And I'm still buying Starbucks coffee. Well, this morning, because I was so hungry, I got their egg bites. I'm like, whatever. The lady already makes my drinks when I'm on the way there. So
because
it was halfway made.
That's a sales thing.
I know. Well, I did.
Sure. $5.
She had to walk me. She walked me through the process of our new machine and how the bag goes in and it twists and then it throws it away for you. Mind blown.
Well,
you can do iced coffee.
I feel like we're in the middle of a TikTok. Tell me you're middle aged without telling me you're middle aged.
The coffee maker is legit.
Yeah. Yet he still buys it from the person at Starbucks because he doesn't want to risk messing up the coffee maker.
And I won't.
That's so funny.
I'll try it today.
Here I am rolling my eyes, and I'm like, the people at, just because of coffee, like, you spend $5 every day on coffee. The people at Sonic are like, hello, Heidi.
Hi, Heidi.
You're regular with your dog, like treats.
Here's your number two.
Nice to see you. Why weren't you here yesterday?
Have you guys seen the new commercials for Sonic with those two girls instead of the two guys?
No.
I don't know if I have.
Oh my gosh. It is so funny. It has nothing. The girls that don't talk about Sonic at all. They're sitting in their car, just like the guys were, the drive through or whatever. And they're talking about like they're eating a burger. And one of them are talking about how they go to Sonic without bras. And they go like in their pajamas. She goes, I hardly ever have a bra on when I go to Sonic. And it just goes like, what? It's the funniest thing.
They know their target market.
Right? It's so funny.
They know who they're talking about.
I never have a bra on.
They probably kind of did a focus group of the people that work the window.
Uh-huh.
Tell us who you see while coming through the drive-thru. What are you seeing?
Ladies don't have bras.
There was that time that guy Pat came through without his underpants on.
No, I had that's right. I didn't. I didn't have underpants, but I had a hold of my shorts. They may have seen my testicles.
I can't judge.
And then he had to reach for his wallet.
Oh.
I think that's exactly what the young girl did in the window.
Oh.
Yeah. I can't judge because undergarment, I mean.
Highly
like,
overrated.
I can't imagine not wearing underwear, but I've gone without the top all the time.
Yes.
I can't even say it.
You mean brassiere?
The top? My under top? I've gone without.
My boob underwear?
I am fully signed on with that. Fully signed on with that. Oh my God. But yeah, the Sonic driver, I remember when I used to have that same thing and I quit going because she knew my name. And I was like, that's it. And she's like, hey Jill, how you doing?
And happened at Qdoba at my last job.
Hi.
Like I just try to shop around so that I have to have a new place that they have to familiarize themselves with me.
Yeah, when it gets too familiar,
so bad.
I know for some people, like Pat, that makes them want to go back.
Oh, yeah.
Because they know his name.
It is nice.
For me, it's like, that's a little too familiar. I think I better go somewhere else for a while.
Yeah.
Oh, my God. So
that's what I've been doing.
Yeah, there you go.
That's it. Not wearing a bra to Sonic. Nothing else, really.
Nothing else happening. Looking for y'all. Trying to find your office. Now, what have you been doing? What has been going on?
Just a lot of activity. You know how summers are? Just
I know
stupid activity.
And you have one kid out of the house, right? Or in college?
Yes.
Okay, one kid out and two still So has your craziness of the summer gotten a little better? Yes.
Oh, for sure. Okay. I mean, Ryan and I see each other now.
That's so weird.
At the same games.
Did you put a picture on social media of you laying on the couch a couple weeks ago? Or is it like a memory? Like you, I for some.
Oh, of like when the kids were little?
Yeah. Or maybe. No, I thought it was recent. Okay. And I remember thinking in my head, oh, she's laying on the couch. That's
weird. I'm on the couch all the time. Okay. Probably with one of the dogs because we came back from vacation and the dogs were like really happy to see me. Which normally they're not. I'm like second fiddle. But they were really happy to see me. But the one I'm thinking of, which I only texted to my mom, which was why you didn't see it, was...
at least you think you texted it to your mom. Maybe you posted it.
She texted it. She's got another guy named Pat in her contacts that occasionally I'll get a softball text for
Pat. I texted it to my dad. My mom is adamant about never having a cell phone. But the picture was for my mom. Had to go through the carrier, my dad.
Okay.
So I'm like, show mom this picture. And Owen, my oldest, who is going to be a sophomore at Lincoln now.
Crazy. Wow.
I know. Because like I just remember bringing him into studio, like way back when. And him saying like I was the best at peeling oranges. Yeah. Like that was,
that was it. That's the highlight. Yeah.
Anyway, he was giving me crap about something, which he hardly ever does. He's turned out to be a lovely, like, mature young man. I just love it. I love when that they, and I never knew this. Like, I only had to, you know, hear from other parents when they turn the corner and they come back and they're not too embarrassed and they're, nothing's a big deal anymore. But he did something recently where, you know, he kind of laughed at something and, oh, I don't know if I would do that, or just gave me a little bit of backlash about something.
Yeah.
And I found this picture in my memories and it was just me. I looked like a baby myself because I was very young when, you know, Owen was born. I think we were married at 22 and first baby at 25, maybe.
Yeah.
I'd have to do the math, which don't trust me.
Don't do the math.
But I was sitting there on the couch with him on his tummy, on my upper thighs, like finally succumbing to sleep. And I remember those days he'd get really kind of gassy and I'd have to put him on my thighs and bounce him and pat him. And it was right after, like, I'm sure nursing for the 47th time that day. And it was just the look of me on that couch with him on my thighs.
Yeah.
And we were both just like, oh my God.
Just exhausted.
So and I sent that to him and I'm like, maybe the next time I ask you to get me, you'll remember this bleepity bleep period of my life where everything revolved around you. Like, I know you like dad better now, but you were on my side 24/7 for like the first 11 years of your life. So he agreed.
Yes.
And he's
good.
You're right, mom. Okay. You're right. Yeah.
He can't, there's no argument. He can't argue that.
I got you have photographic evidence.
I did. And of course it was like, I had to take a picture of an actual printed picture. Because that's how long ago this was.
Oh, my God. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's always a fun one. But mom, I finally got mom turned the corner herself with the cell phone, right?
Oh, see, I'm impressed.
She got the cell phone. She was on board with that, but she didn't want to get a smartphone.
Uh-huh.
And tried forever. And dad wanted one. She wouldn't even let him get one because she didn't see the need.
Yeah.
And dad wanted one. Oh, we don't need that. That's just, that's ridiculous.
So they still have a landline?
Yes.
So do mine.
Yes. Absolutely. Yep. I still do.
I did not know this about her.
There's nothing attached to it, but it's still there.
Okay.
It's totally to brand with her, though.
Yeah, yeah. But that's funny.
Because when the grid goes down, I've still got a phone. True. Anyway.
And a backpack full of Rush Limbaugh food.
Actually, it's Glumbeck, but whatever. Maybe it's Mongini.
Or whatever. One of those guys. Whatever the logo is on
whatever
the
back. Whatever is the best discount, I can't remember. Anyway.
Promo code Mongino.
Yeah, see who calls me when they just see. You'll just see on my landline, no less. He'll figure it out. Anyway, they finally decided to get the smartphone. Yeah, love it. Everything's great. Mom got it because all of her girlfriends, they were texting.
Yes. And she was out.
She was out of the loop.
Out of loop. Yep.
And you could text on her phone, but it was that T-touch, you know, how it used to be. Do you hit three threes and then two, that, you know, trying to get the right letters? And you could do it without looking at your phone. Do you remember those days?
Because you feel it out.
Yes. Yep. And then smartphones were awful because you couldn't do that. But anyway, so they finally got the phone. So now every once in a while she wants to send me something. And I say, well, just send me a picture of it. Mm-hmm. Or she's trying to describe something to me that's happening on her computer screen. Or she has a picture that she came across. I'll have to bring them with me Sunday so you can see it. Send me a picture of it.
Uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
I could totally do that.
I can do that. Yep. And so send me a picture of it. Or when they want something or they're looking for a product or something like that, they'll take a picture of it and send it to me instead of trying to describe it.
Nice.
Much easier.
I walked my dad through. He sent a text to the wrong person, and it was a long length. He didn't want to text out. I walked him through copying from the old text, starting a new text, pasting it.
Holy cow.
And you know, you can't you can't FaceTime that crap because he has to see it. Like I'm on my phone, he's on his phone.
To be very, use your words.
Used my words.
Yes.
Felt
did he get
good.
Frustrated? Did he?
Well, so here's the funniest part. He said, "Well, you know, because I texted the wrong person. I did .gov instead of .com." And I was like,
"What?
Okay, I'll walk you through this, and then when we're done,
he said he texted to a .gov instead of a .com.
But here's the deal: you can text to emails. You know this, right?
Yes, you can. Yeah.
So
totally.
I just walked him through the whole process, and then I was like, Let's circle back to the first part of this discussion.
What are your contacts?
Are we texting or are we text emailing? Well, you know, so
right?
Apparently it went
thing.
Through. It went through. That's all that matters. I said, you just need to realize that if you did the email, unless you put your name or phone number, like no one's going to know who you are.
Yeah.
Unless they have your cell number memorized.
If you text to email, it'll just show your phone number.
Correct.
Because we get those.
Yeah, we do.
Yeah. Yes. So anyway, we've passed that
I
milestone.
Love it.
Awesome. Many things I've done this summer.
It's like the progressive commercial. The guy.
Oh my god!
Is this hashtagging?
Yes. How to be?
We're gonna open a P. That's I texted someone to a .gov. Hold on.
I could be on the progressive commercial 100%. With my TV remote in my basement.
Why? What
I have
is
no
that?
Idea. I have no idea how to operate the basement TV.
Why? Why is it so hard?
Because it's different than the living room TV.
It's like a big smart remote or just a.
There's more than one remote, which is part of the problem.
You know what I wonder? What I wonder, because that we went through that phase, there was that era, and so some people have their setups, and like I've still have a flat screen TV that's like 12 years old, right? Because they last a pretty good amount of time, but they were also weighed 500 pounds.
Yes, yes,
right. They were heavy, and now the little ones you can pick it up with one hand and throw it across the room. But it's so much easier now. But once you have your setup, and you've got your speakers, and you've got your all the other stuff that's on there. And so you've got three different remotes that are running. One turns the TV on, one runs the volume, and something else runs your Roku or
and then
something.
The sound bar.
Right?
And,
and instead of upgrading everything, because you'd have to just reassign everything. But once you know how to do all that, it's really cool. Once you get rid of it and get the new one that's like a Roku TV.
Why did I do this a long time ago?
And everything is on one little remote, and I can just push a button and tell the remote what I want.
Yeah, yeah. Well, we're not there yet.
God.
So I am comfortable with my living room setup. But I'm telling you, if I get thrown into the basement, my kids and my husband, I mean, they just die. Like, they're like, why is this so hard?
Why? Is it you can't turn it on? You can't switch from channel to channel?
There is no natural, nothing is intuitive.
Nothing has sunk in over the last couple of years
No, because I literally, I don't want to go to the igloo basement, number one. And then when I'm down there, way too many remotes. And I just know that I'm the typical mom who's just, you know, that everybody makes fun of, which is fine. I don't even care. But I will say the biggest bonus last night I stumbled upon, I don't know if it's just a trial. I have no idea. It hasn't asked me to pay yet. So I know I'm not in trouble with Ryan.
Okay.
I stumbled upon Ted Lasso, which I kept hearing over and over about.
I haven't watched that either.
Oh, you gotta watch it.
What is it called?
So Ted Lasso. It's Jason Sudeikis. From Saturday Night Live, and it's the story, and I don't know the whole story, of course, but he gets thrown into this professional soccer as a coach, coach of this franchise, and it's all the owner's ex-wife. The owner cheats on the, and this is all done in the first episode. The owner cheats multiple times on the ex-wife, and so she's going to stick it to him by purposely hiring this idiot coach to run their program into the dirt. But it turns out that Ted Lasso is this amazing motivator. Who can influence a team to do?
I've heard that show is fantastic,
and I'm telling you, I've watched two episodes, and I'm so giddy that
Is it Apple TV or HBO?
I found it on Apple.
I think it's Apple TV. Yeah, yeah.
I'm telling you, I stumbled upon it.
I don't have Apple TV.
I didn't think we did either, Jill. You might.
Yeah, you might. Just go on and turn on TV. Search Ted Lasso.
I'll go see I won't have Apple TV on my Roku.
You might be able to download an app. You might be able to.
I wonder if there is an app for that.
I don't know.
I'll have to check. I will check.
I'm just telling you. That's my. If you walk away with one thing with Heidi podcast, Ted Lasso.
Yeah.
Two episodes in, I'm like, and there's two seasons.
I'm telling you, if anything, somebody who needs something new to watch, it's me, because I feel like I have watched everything that's on Netflix.
You basically wrung it out.
I have, and now I'm on Tubi. Is it Tubi? TUBI.
I don't know. WeTV?
No, Tubi. TUBI.
I think I've heard you mention it.
Come on.
It's never mind. It's
she doesn't even know how she's getting Ted Lasso on her TV. Don't ask her about the other stuff.
And I like it because it's got some obscure older movies on it.
Uh-huh.
Things that you forgot about that are halfway decent. And so I've been kind of watching some of that. And I'm like, I am scraping the bottom of the barrel.
I think you'll like it, Jill.
I need to find a new source. A new well.
Yeah. That's what I'm pretty sure you can, there's an app, maybe it's not on Roku, but there's a way you can get Apple TV.
Okay.
Because they wouldn't, they wouldn't just keep it just to Apple people.
No, because they want you to pay for it.
100%.
If there's a way to get you to.
And there's other, like the morning show with Jennifer Aniston. I've watched it, but I've heard it's really good and that's on Apple TV.
Okay.
And it's been out a couple years ago. Yeah. So it's other stuff you can watch.
All right. We'll see what we can do. We'll try that out. God. Anyway, so when do the kids go back to school? I saw the picture. You said you're going to be recreating the locker
the
picture.
The epic locker picture because JC will be moving into junior high. So we've got...
can you believe that?
Sophomore in college, senior in high school, seventh grader. In Bellevue Junior High is just seventh and eighth. I know in Millard it's... middle school, sixth or eighth, right?
Yeah, sixth, seventh, eighth. Mm-hmm.
With a weird pickup half day on Wednesday.
Right, which was always odd.
Yeah.
Which I didn't understand that because of other schools were, like the elementary schools were getting out, whatever.
Yeah.
Did not know that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wednesdays were always
But, you know, earlier. I was a seventh and eighth grade junior high.
Uh-huh.
That was old school. That's the old school way.
Yeah. And you can't call it junior high anymore because nobody knows what you're talking about.
Well, in Bellevue they do though.
Oh, it's called junior high?
It's still called junior high, yes.
Oh.
Yeah, we haven't upgraded because you know what? If it ain't broke.
Why fix it?
Correct.
Call the junior high on your landline.
I cannot believe she has a landline. Jill had to step out. I'm gonna let the listeners
totally.
Know. Jill had to step out, and so now it's time to rip up and
I
down.
Can she 100% totally, she says nothing's connected to it. What until about, I think, 6 months ago,
yeah.
She had an answering machine.
Oh my God. So, why did you tell me? I would have called that and left.
I don't know
all
the number. I don't even think I have the number
on
my phone.
God.
I don't have that now. I know I don't have that number. It's, because she says she gives that or would give that number out to like telemarketers to get them. Like they don't care.
Right, right. So what's the Morse code? I feel like that's going to be in her basement. It's Morse code.
Yeah,
but Morse what's code. The thing called? I don't know. Teletyper. I don't know.
God, what's it called? telegram? Telegraph? Telegraph
it's
machine?
Definitely not a telegram. That wouldn't be 100%. Like on a Pony Express.
Yeah.
And here's the deal. Like, she will live. Like, she will survive way longer than me. But my thought is... I don't care if my life is shorter as long as it's more convenient.
Right. As long as... Yeah, I don't want to be living in a ditch with a backpack full of food.
Yeah, good for you right? for those extra couple years. That had
and who
to
are you
going to
call on your landline? You can't text on it. And I hate calling people on the phone. I hate it. So I don't
know.
You can't text on a landline.
Well, you're one of those that every now and then when I text, I'm like, I'm not sure if I'm going to hear back. And I know you're not like mean about it, but I've got a lot of friends who are like that. And because I'm an over-texter and I know that about myself.
Well... Okay, Beth is the same way. Beth is the most responsive human being on texts or messages ever.
Yeah, yeah.
Like she'll be on the couch and she'll have, because I have my notifications muted and like my watch will vibrate or whatever. She has everything on. So when she gets any notification, even on whatever Instagram, it's bing, boing, bells and whistles. She gets in there right away and responds. And it's impressive. But I just can't do it.
The deal is, it's okay. So it's impressive. Like it's good for the people who reach out to you. But I will say as someone who is like that, it is such a burden to be like constantly interrupted throughout the day.
Yeah,
like
true.
I can't focus. I mean, I already have focus issues. Let's be honest.
Then you mix in a text in the middle of it.
So then when people say, I've got people who I work with that are like, we shut down our emails for up to 3 hours a day to handle our high priority, projects. And I'm like, I really need to do that.
Like shut down your email, like just close Outlook out and don't even
so that you don't have the auto notice come up.
Doesn't that drive you nuts?
It would drive me nuts. But here's the deal. I would get a lot of stuff done. Because don't you think, truly, I have maybe, let's say I get 55 emails before lunch hour, which is not uncommon. I bet four of them are semi-urgent and the rest of them, like if I didn't get back to them until after 2 o'clock in the afternoon, it's no big deal.
Right.
And in fact, some 100%. Of them, things might be resolved by 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
And you don't even need to mess with it.
Correct.
Yes.
So
I'm with you.
I feel like I should do that more.
I'm with you.
Like I should exercise.
Like I should read.
I do read. And let me tell you,
what do you read?
Okay, so this is, it's pretty weighty stuff. I'm doing the Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants series.
What?
Which I've never read before.
That's a series? I thought it was just two movies.
No, so it's a series, and I'm on book three or four. There's at least four books, I know. I think I'm on book three.
Oh, I had no clue it was a book.
So here's the funny deal. A friend of mine recommended that I get the Yaya Sisterhood. And I, you know, again, with my distracted brain, by the time I went to the library, because I'm old and I check books out from the library, I brought it out to my car and we do Marco Polo.
Okay.
And I like flashed her. I'm like, guess what? I got the traveling pants. Oh, yeah. I'm going to dive right into your recommendation. And so her next video, she's like cracking up and she's like, not the book I recommended. But,
so you have the Sister of the Traveling Pants and then the Yaya Club.
I still haven't read yet.
So you meant to get pants, but you got Yaya or the other way around?
Reverse. And I'm telling you, the Sisterhood of the Traveling Pants, it's a really good series. Like, I really, really enjoy it. I stumbled upon Ted Lasso and I got the wrong book, and I'm so happy for these mistakes. These happy little mistakes. I feel like Bob Ross.
I love it. Happy trees. I love it when you find, because I always lead with TVs and movie and not book, and then you watch a movie and you realize, just like now, I had no clue that that was a book series.
Yeah.
So you're like, oh my gosh, you're kidding me. That was a book series?
Correct.
What did I miss? Hold on, I had to step out of the room just for a second.
Oh, no, we did. We told everybody to step out of the room. So we gave our opinions on your landline. Listen to the Pat and JT podcast to find out how Heidi really feels.
Tune in.
It's not even plugged into anything, but it's there.
It's sitting there. I didn't know you were coming up until yesterday, but I was going to, this happened on Wednesday, and we were talking about taking pictures of things, right? Yeah. And sending them to people.
Yes.
I'm not the kind of, like, when you see these people on TikTok or Instagram or whatever, and they have a video of, oh my gosh, a deer running across this and jumps over it. Like, I would never think to grab my camera and video it.
Because I'd just with my mouth open going,
like, this is amazing. And then you try to tell people. Uh-huh. So I'm driving on Q Wednesday from work, actually. And it's rush hour traffic is terrible anyway.
Yeah.
But it was like, it was more brakey than normal, like more red brake lights in front of me. And so I'm thinking, something's got to be going on. Accident. I didn't see any flashing lights or anything. And all of a sudden I see this woman, like I'm probably 10 cars in front of me. I'm back. And I see this, run across the street and right in the middle of queue, super busy. And I see arms go up in the air. And I'm like, oh, something's going down. So I remembered to actually grab my phone. I'm like, okay, this is it. I'm going to grab my phone. While I'm driving.
Lots of lights.
I didn't actually get anything on video you couldn't see because they already pulled into the auto zone.
Oh.
But this lady was ran across the street from Walgreens right there and like went in the oncoming traffic and stopped them. Must have been somebody that she knew and bashed on their hood.
Oh.
I saw that. You couldn't catch up. Yeah. And then, so that person and the person behind them pulled into AutoZone and she's cussing and going like this. And she doesn't look like a degenerate. She just looked pissed.
Mad.
Yeah. And she was pissed at something. And so then by the time they pulled off, everybody started moving and I couldn't hear anything. I couldn't see what was going on. She was screaming at something. Yeah.
Interesting.
It was the weirdest thing.
There was a video, speaking of which, and when you mentioned just people thinking to grab their phone, saw a video yesterday from the Bronx, New York, and somebody grabbed their phone because the cops were trying to pull a car over. Why they decided to video it? Because at that point, there was nothing really going on. And all of a sudden, the car just lunged forward, hit the car in front of it, backed up, hit the car behind it.
Oh, my God.
Backed and just kept going back and forth and turned around and then took off and hit another car to push it out of the way. It was a disaster. I've never seen anything like it. But the cops were right there, but they couldn't get anybody out of the car.
Yeah.
And there were no plates on the car. And the car was just, they were trying to get them out and the doors were locked. They tried to open the doors. They had their guns drawn.
Oh, my God.
But they literally just bang, bang, bang. And then they ended up on the sidewalk and drove down the sidewalk. And people are jumping off the sidewalk and then went away. And I'm like, how did you even know to start videoing that? Uh-huh. Because I would have been standing there in shock watching this.
Yeah.
And the very beginning of it was completely innocuous. It just looked like a regular police interaction, you know, no big deal. But they happened to catch all that. And I was like, what is going on?
Some people have that default in their DNA to grab their camera. It's just not that.
But again, this is the generation like our kids are growing up with. And I always tell them that. Mm-hmm. Like, everybody has a camera on them at all times. The time.
You know something else, too? They need to, and I've said this before 1,000 times when I'm driving, every day I run into this. You think you're good at driving and texting. You're not.
Yeah.
Because I'm behind you.
Yes.
And you're weaving.
Yes. You think you're good, but you're not.
Or you're slowing down unknowingly.
Uh-huh.
right? And you're just like, oh my God, would you look at the road? Would you please lift your eyes up?
Because- have you ever honked when someone's been driving like you? No, I don't even mean in front of you. Like I've had someone drive by me. I'm turning into like,
oh my God.
I used to be a bad texter and I tried
to on the way to the
now.
Library to
yeah,
get
on the way to the library to get the book that I was wrong, but I ended up loving. And like if someone comes, like coming around the corner, that's what I'm talking about. Like they're on their phone on the corner and every now and then I'll just be like, and then I'll go just wave. Like, hey.
I see you.
Yeah, I see you.
And every time, or that, or after you get an opportunity to go around them. This is a very Midwestern thing. You probably follow the Midwestern, whatever it's called on Facebook and Twitter. Midwestern people or something like that.
I've seen lots of
hilarious stuff that Midwesterners do. But you, after you get that opportunity to get by him, and then you hurry up and speed up to get right next to him so you can turn and look at him.
I just give them that glare.
And realizing they didn't even know I was behind them.
I think I'm a little too passive aggressive to give the side glare.
Yeah.
I might speed right by them, and then when we get to the stoplight, look straight ahead. Look straight ahead. Roll my window up. I'm mad at you. But I'm not brave enough to give you the side eye.
I'll give you stink eye. I give stink eye. I'm just like, what is wrong with you?
I'm mad at you, but I'm a total wuss. Yeah. But I'm super mad.
No, I did marry my polar opposite. Who will stare as we pass? Who will stare in the rearview mirror? Who will stare in the side mirror? I'm like, oh my God. Just drop it. I'm like over here in the fetal position, rocking back and forth.
Do you ever do the hands in the air?
And I yell some.
Yeah, I've done that.
I yell some things.
Yeah, some cussies.
Some cussies, like, for sure.
What is wrong with you? Your hands are up in the air. You're looking at them. You're hoping they catch you in the rearview mirror, but they're too busy on their phone to notice. Yes.
I do feel a tinge of guilt, though, whenever you're like, what the hell? Then it's like a 93-year-old. And you're like, oh,
but it's
hi,
still
grandma.
Frustrating, though. I know. It's still frustrating. That's even sometimes more frustrating. When the grandma or grandpa is, they're driving like 5. And you're like, oh my God, just go.
I'm like, you're going to get, I'm worried they're going to get hit.
I know.
I mean, because some people just aren't, because everybody's behind you looking at their phone.
Correct.
Going 68.
Yes.
Then it's totally like out of character for a young person to be driving that slow. So when somebody's obviously driving slow in front of you and then you go around them and it's like a 22-year-old, you're like, loser, go. Like, what are you doing? Every time I look, I'm like, what are you doing? Go. They're going like the speed limit.
Just drive like you're trying to go somewhere.
Right.
That's all I want you to do.
Yeah. And people that can't decide to turn, they slow turn and they're looking like, oh my God, just go.
Speaking of driving on patterns, they said, and I don't know who reported this, someone on my social media had said that truck drivers, there was a post that went kind of viral about how they miss kids doing the
motion.
Really? Yeah. Mm-hmm. I'll just go ahead and demonstrate it. That's really good for podcasts.
Yeah, so it's good. Because kids aren't...
Because everybody's on their phone.
They're on their phones.
So
they don't care anymore.
The
yeah.
poor semi-drivers are just like, hey, guys, I got a horn.
Oh, my gosh.
So I think about that. Think about that when you're on your kids with your next little road trip. They're going to be mortally embarrassed, but who cares? Just say, hey, try to give that. See what happens.
Yeah.
You might get flipped off. You might get a honk.
And that's actually kind of a fun little game. Flip off
right.
a honk.
Like, is he or she a nice truck driver?
Yeah.
Or are they jaded and
most
hate
of them
you?
Are nice.
Like, let's teach our kids about the real world.
Yeah. Will they run us into the rubble bar? What are those things called?
Rumble strips?
Yeah.
Rumble bars?
Rubble bars?
Rubble bars. Into the rubble bars.
Come on.
I hit the rubble bars.
Go back to the library, Grandma. The rubble bars. The hell's that?
Oh, I missed you guys.
Well, maybe you need to come in more regular.
Yeah, you're a little closer now, so that's good.
Yeah,
I know that was part of. I know that was part of your plan was to get a little
get closer to you.
Sharpie County.
That was all. That's all that mattered. That's what was one of the first things we asked when
we wouldn't have sold the herd at it. They weren't closer to you.
I appreciate that because you have to take care of the OGs.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
yes.
There's only one OG. Well, really, it's like Andy was in this week, so two OGs in 1 week.
And Clay.
Clay's an OG.
Yep.
He's been back. Psychic Andy's episode was good.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
He's fun. I missed him. I mean, it's just been way too long. He's had so much going on.
Yeah.
And dude rolls out of COVID down like 15 pounds.
I know.
He's
I heard
got
you
pipes.
Say that.
It's like, dude.
So I was so debating if you were going to ask, like, you know, I guess you did ask what's up, but I was going to say, like, oh, you know, I've lost like 20 pounds. And to see if you like faked the reaction, like, oh, I thought you looked good. And I was going to be like, this is such bullshit. Like, I have not, but thanks for being fake.
Yeah. All right.
I should have done it.
You should have.
I should have.
Yeah. Because
I'm down a couple sizes. You'd be like, oh, I totally, yeah.
Get it, yeah.
You look
I was
going to
say that.
That's it. Because I gained 40, I've lost 20. That's why you can't tell.
Uh-huh. I saw something funny on TikTok the other day that said, if you're worried about your weight and you've gained weight over quarantine or whatever, just if you meet new people, just let them know that you're down 100 pounds from where you were. So you're on your way down. So you're looking fantastic.
Right? You're feeling good.
Yeah, I was 350.
Right?
So my 196... I'm halfway to goal, yo.
That's a great way to
here
look
I
it.
Am. Yeah. I've got the Cheers theme song every time I pull into Sonic. Oh. Where everybody knows your name. I would like the bacon croissant. My normal. Thank you. Thank you, Leslie. Have a great one. Have the kids do it.
That's right. Is Tony working today? Say hi.
Thank you, Leslie. That's the name of our podcast today. Thank you, Leslie.
Oh my God! Speaking of the TikToks, do you watch a lot of TikToks?
I do.
So he sent me one this morning because it's a conspiracy theory TikTok.
Oh, mm-hmm. I'm sure there's whole channels dedicated.
Oh my God!
You could go down a rabbit hole.
So much fun. Oh, I came in this morning hot because I had all kinds of stuff that I'd been reading yesterday.
Uh huh.
Oh my God! Yeah, and I just stood in his doorway. Just like vomiting all this conspiracy.
And I knew that was gonna happen. Like you, it's if you're like wake up in the morning, you're in an argument with whoever, and you wake up and you're like, are you still mad? And then they just go.
Yes,
that was like
yes.
Just sending her a TikTok about a conspiracy theory.
Yes.
Priming the pump. So I knew she was gonna come in hot with stats and graphs.
Like, uh-huh. Oh my God, you are not gonna believe this. And he just sat there like, what?
Yeah.
What did I just do? Gasoline on the fire. Uh-huh.
Jack is sure as shit tired of hearing about it, so trust me. I'm sorry, you were just the only one here.
Well, and because I know that Jack does hear about it, because just here in their office, you have complete conversations with yourself.
Uh-huh.
I'll be
uh-huh.
sitting in my office and I'll hear her go, what? Well, that's weird. I don't understand. Well, let's go over here. Okay. I'm going to put this. Yes. That is odd. I don't understand. And I'm thinking, am I missing a meeting? Like, honestly, and she'll go, where is that? I'll hear her chair. Oh, here it is. It's like, I've been looking for this. Like, oh my gosh.
That's funny.
I don't do it as much anymore.
Oh, I don't know.
I close the door.
I feel like to get super into conspiracy theories, you have to be willing to think a lot harder. But like if you don't understand your downstairs remote, you're probably not going to be a conspiracy theory girl.
100% agree with that. We're more, you and I are more surface people.
Well, I mean, TikTok yes. works. I will watch TikTok till the cows come home.
It's really funny though, how I am able to, you're able to conjure the stuff that you like the best on TikTok and TikTok knows.
Yeah. The algorithms, they'll feed you everything.
Oh my God. It is feeding me a buffet.
Uh-huh.
I am like, oh my God, it's so hard to get off of TikTok because
it is.
Each one is a little bit better than the one before. And I'm like, oh my God.
So fess up, how many times have you had the young kids say, hey, I know it's been fun, but it might be time for you to take a break now. Have you had that? Mm-hmm. And I'm always like,
okay,
oh my
these
God.
These videos will be here tomorrow.
Yeah. I'm getting schooled by a 23-year-old about how I'm wasting my life. That's great.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I've had that. I've had the kids swipe through my FYP a couple times.
Yeah. I'm like, oh God, that's bad.
Yeah.
But I've only been on and I'll look at the clock for 98 minutes. Oh God!
Yeah, it's like I don't know where time goes when you're on TikTok. It's like this vortex.
Yeah,
because it's such nice little easy bites.
Yeah,
yeah,
nice little easy.
So
bites.
Okay, yeah. So what are your top? So what's being fed to you besides the conspiracy theory? Well, mine are dogs and sports videos.
Dogs, definitely. I do have a lot of dog ones, especially like German Shepherd and police dog ones.
Uh huh.
And I don't know how. No, it's like, do we just get lucky here, or is it? I don't know. When you first start, it's like it sends you just this random everything. I guess trying to slowly figure out what it is that you like to see more of. And so, yeah, there's a lot of that. There's some recipes.
Yeah, those are bypassing.
You think shortcuts. I was keto? If you look at my FYP,
I'm looking right. Not real recipes. Talking like
four ingredient hacks. Recipes. Yes,
yeah. Like and hacks.
Yeah,
things that make things easier. A lot of how tos, or do it yourself kind of stuff too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, mm-hmm. I like that kind of stuff. Yep.
Yeah, same. It's a lot of food. You think I was keto? Like there's a lot of keto stuff, and I'm not keto.
Have you seen the one about the avocado? That if you know how taking the seed
out.
Yeah, and to pop it out with just your thumb. And I love all the fails on it because everybody's trying to do it. And it's like you have to have the perfectly ripened avocado in order to do it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, your fingers just go right through the avocado.
Yeah.
Because it's mush, right?
Yeah.
It's not going to work. But it is pretty cool when you saw it the first time because you're like.
Because you never thought about that, doing that.
It's and like, all those people that cut their hand off trying to whack it with a knife to twist it out.
It's
like, and I'm
it's not that difficult.
Oh, I do get a lot of the, this is more on Snapchat, but I get a lot of the health and beauty, like pimple popper type. And ooh. I'm like, do I really watch as many of those? Because it grosses me out every time, but it's being fed.
But do you keep watching? Do you watch it?
I do. At least half of it. And then when you know it's about to get really bad.
Zip.
I don't have the 23-year-old tell me to turn away anymore. That's when I get off the videos.
Getting the zits?
Yeah, I'm like, nope, done.
I'm off.
Yeah, I can't. Dr. Pimple Popper is her name, right?
Yeah, she has a TV show now, too, on like TLC or something.
I can't watch
it. There was one, which I know you've got your heart. It was with, agriculture, farming, horses, cattle. There was one that a cow had an abscess that they...
I've seen that one. It's absolutely awesome. It's like a fountain.
Like, who in my friend list thought that would be okay to post? Because that was like a Facebook one. And
it was? And somebody...
Screw you for putting this out there, because I had to watch...
It was awful.
It was... But they're like, thank God the poor cow has to feel so much better now. And I'm like, well, because there's a freaking geyser out of its leg.
Yeah, I would hope so. It was so awful.
Oh,
hopefully no one's eating this during or listening to this during breakfast. But
so gross.
She's bad.
Yeah, that's so disgusting.
Yeah, I can't watch those kind of videos.
Anyway, I don't know how bad to do it. Anyway, in summary.
And you know what's weird is that I can watch, because I really, really, when I was a kid, I wanted to be a vet.
Uh-huh.
Really did. Horse vet. That was my whole thing. I even went to Iowa State to their vet college when I was in high school to go watch operations.
Oh, yeah.
You know, and watch procedures.
That'd be cool.
That's what I really wanted to do. I can watch and help with my animals.
Uh-huh.
Doesn't faze me.
Yeah.
But when it's on a person.
Yeah.
I just can't even look. I can't even.
Yeah, I can't either.
Ooh.
These people that watch videos of injuries, like sports injuries, can't do it.
No.
My wife does. She doesn't care. She's like, whatever. She wants to see them all. I still haven't seen that one. Andre Ware, I think, that broke
his
leg.
Kevin Ware.
I still have not seen that video or the picture. I can't. Thank God. I was watching the game. I didn't see it, though.
So they replayed it once. I don't know if you knew. Mm-mm. They replayed it. And then, because even the sportscasters didn't realize what they were seeing
initially. Right?